we consider ourselves being a universe filled with the void on which we can start the new creation, there is also the feeling of light, sunshine. We are made 70% of who we are comes, the energy comes from the sunlight. And when the sun is no longer present, we have all kinds of spiritual and mental and emotional illness. So we want to acknowledge this universes of sunlight and universes of darkness coexist in our life all the time. And when the darkness prevails, we can always look for the sunshine. And sunshine sometimes is not visible, but it's there. So it's up to us to find them, to find the streaks of light, even in the darkest place. So I'm bringing some light into the corners of my awareness, because I truly believe that the star energy is very important, but without the sunlight, we would not see the dark starry night. And then I want to bring the red, a little bit of the red. This is the physical realm where the human blood is being spilled. And there is the human blood that connects us all the time. We are connected through the red thread of our existence. Somewhere in the universe, there are people who need to meet. Where in the universe, our bloodline is connected to other bloodlines. And again, as you bring this color, think about the red thread that connects you and all the people that are coming into collaborating with you and all the people who are helping you to create, starting with your mother and father. Without their bloodline, you probably would not exist in the physical realm. So as a spirit, we do choose who we incarnate to. What is the family and what is the circumstance and geography and biology? And that's what the stars reveal. The stars above in the sky on the day and time where you were born. So we're going to go on a visual quest into a place between the layers. So I invite you to close your eyes and imagine yourself being that portal that we've just created. The purples and blues and reds and yellow, all of the colors are playing and inviting you into the physical form. But before the physical form appears, we are going to go and look. What did you mean to be before you even incarnated? So close your eyes and we're going to go back very safely into the past where you were just a flow of spirit, the life between lives. And I'm going to count to 10 and you're going to slowly descend into that space while you're being in your physical body, just watching, just opening your inner eyes to the idea that at one day, at one point, you were just the void of creation and unseparated consciousness united with all there is. 1, 2, 3, going deeper and deeper. 4, 5, 6. Seeing the colors of your portal, 7, 8, 9, being ready to embrace the portal, 10, being in the portal. And in that portal, you are a spirit creating physical body. I'm going to count to 5 and you're going to see that body. How does it look like? 1, 2, 3, getting ready to see, imagine, or just know how your body would look like. 4 and 5. As I think about my body, I see the Buddha. And the Buddha is the image of a person sitting under the tree, connecting to the heaven and earth, becoming a bridge between what is and what will be. And I think of myself as a bodhisattva, the one that comes back to fix the problems. And it keeps coming back even though there is no problems. But in the human consciousness, we always look for problems and then we look for solutions to these problems. So I see myself as the one who finds the shapes and colors and forms that represent solutions. So I see the image of me descending to earth under my tree, creating a space for those who want to find the solutions in shape, forms, and colors. And as you see your image, that being that is coming into your mind or idea of how you would like to be, I invite you to open your eyes and sketch. Create a little sketch of how you see yourself incarnated. Who would you rather be? You don't have to be who you are right now, this moment. You can be anything you want to be, or you can be you. It's up to you. What would you like to bring into the form and how that form would look like in this moment of time, inviting you into this rebirth. So open your eyes safely and gently, take your journal and write down anything that you've seen or anything that you know or anything that you imagine.